Welcome back to Vegas Live with Nina. Oh, it's so exciting interviewing all these great guests. You know, they all have so many different stories, but it all seems to turn around to sort of entertainment and music and what's going on in Las Vegas, because that's what our show is all about. Our show is all about presenting people from Las Vegas, even outside of Las Vegas, but mostly in the music industry and the entertainment business, though we do other, you know, interviews as well. But this particular one right now, I have Raven with me. I've known Raven. How long have I known you, Raven? A few years now.
It's been a few years.
But last time I saw him, he had this incredible black hair. What happened? Well, you got gray.
The problem was keeping it black.
I would
inevitably end up with a skunk stripe after a week or so, and it just got to be... it ceased being
too
practical.
Too much to keep up. So I know exactly what you mean.
I took it all off.
I do go through the procedure.
Right. I let about an inch or so grow out, and I took it all off, and I actually had short hair for a while, which was the first time for about 30 years.
Wow. Now, Raven, obviously, you are one of the greatest guitar players. Am I saying it right? In the music business. But you sing.
No, I play guitar.
You play the guitar.
Yes.
I did get it right. You play the guitar, but you are amazing at it. You're very, very good. So you were in a band then, and what band? Are you still in the same band? Or?
Well, last time I was here, I was in a band, a Deep Purple tribute band.
That's right.
The Sound of Purple, and we had some really great players. The problem is that in Las Vegas, especially, it's hard to. It's hard to maintain a band because...
Why is it so hard to maintain a band in Vegas? I hear this all the time.
Well, a lot of times it's because guys are in multiple bands. And so if you have a band and you're trying to keep it going and book gigs, you know, your bass player might be in a couple other bands. Your singers and keyboard players especially... usually are in multiple bands, so you have to kind of juggle everybody's schedule to be able to book
is that good? Because that could be good. It could be good and bad, because it could be that you couldn't have many gigs, but then if you have a band and half your band is in another band and you want to perform, you don't have a gig.
There's some musicians, I have some really good friends out there that make their living playing in multiple bands, and they're playing somewhere every weekend almost, and that's great for
that's
them.
That's really good for them.
That's great for them, but if you're one of those bands, the manager or the leader of the band that's trying to schedule around everybody who's available, and sometimes you might have to call in other musicians to
sub. Well, if they're in the band every week, you can't even get them.
That happens.
So what
a lot
are you
times.
Doing now? So you're the great guitar. Are you also in this sort of floating around now?
No, I was never able to maintain... I could never think of what I had to do for more than one band at a time. I actually tried that one time, and it was a disaster.
For you it was.
So I like to focus on one
on
band
one
and put all
band.
My efforts into just the one project. Right now, I'm in a band called Burn Unit.
That sounds cool.
Yeah, there's some really great musicians there. The drummer I played with in another band called Lady Chameleon with Miranda Trenholm. And
that's how you kind of got your band together through him?
That's how I ended up in Burn Unit. He played guitar in that other band, though. I played guitar with him, and I didn't even realize he was a drummer at first until I actually went and saw Burn Unit, and I was amazed.
And he was a drummer at that time.
He wasn't
playing. He wasn't playing the guitar.
No.
He was playing the drum. And you didn't realize that. So now you've got somebody playing something else for another part of your band.
Right. A lot of these guys I'm playing with now are just great musicians. They can play a lot of different instruments. And Kelly is great at both guitar, drums, and he plays bass in the U2 tribute as well with the guitar player.
It's amazing what I've noticed with a lot of these people that are in bands. They play more than one instrument. And they've got this rally of instruments. I can't even barely play one. Never mind. Do you do the same thing?
Well, I am going to start playing some keyboards in this band, which I've done before. I did an album many years ago that I played the keyboard tracks myself on a couple songs. But it's something that I actually have to practice the technique for. You know,
you have to practice every day. To get
it's something that I'm going to have
different.
To build up a little bit. Yes,
absolutely.
Because I've always focused mostly on guitar.
Yeah.
But
so now you're bringing another entity into your life, which is super. Why
it's
not?
It's going to be fun. I wish I could play drums. I actually
so learn it.
Originally,
you've got the motor. You know, you've got the brains working the same way.
Well,
you know. Yeah. You know, we always limit ourselves, and I often wonder why people limit themselves when, you know, try it. I was singing last night with Dana Day. I was singing Dana.
I saw the post.
Oh, no, how an embarrassment.
Oh, it was great.
I've never sung before. That was the first time I've ever sung. And she says, Nina, you know the words? And I said, no, I don't. I can look at them and memorize them and pretend I know them. That's how I was doing it. But that was, so I apologize to everybody out there because this really was my first singing gig, or singing at any time. I've never sung before. I've never actually done that. So, hey, was I all right?
Well, yeah, you were great. Better than I would be. I've done
something.
Limited singing. I'm normally not one that you want to get near a microphone.
Well, I thought I was the same way, but maybe.
But, no, we're playing New Year's Eve, actually, at the Eastside Cannery.
Eastside Cannery, that's
right.
A big gig.
Yeah.
I think I may have seen you that one time. I know I saw you at Mesquite.
You saw us, the Deep Purple tribute, you saw us in Mesquite, and you did come to a couple other shows.
Yes, I came to another show.
At the Eastside Cannery.
Was there with you.
Yeah, that's a great place to play. The people there are... Well, the cannery, we played the Northside Cannery too,
yes.
And the cannery people in general
are
really
nice.
Great.
Yeah, it's great.
It's a really great place to play, and we fill up the room pretty good.
I'm not surprised they wouldn't fill up because they are amazing. I don't know about this group, but I know when you were the Purple group, I know that was absolutely amazing.
Well, same quality musicians, definitely.
Wasn't there a guy there that was singing with the long hair?
Stevens.
Steve, that was
he.
Is, Steven,
as far as
he?
I know, he no longer has long hair, as I didn't for a little while either. It's getting there, but he has another band as well.
They all shift around.
Yeah, that's what happened with the Deep Purple tribute. Basically, is that everybody had other commitments, and by the time we did that gig in Chicago with Barb Bailey, involved in that. We had a keyboard player, a brilliant keyboard player named Kurt Nelson, who is based out of Seattle. Our bass player at the Ken Tone was about to move to California, so the band was kind of scattering, and it would have required a gig of, you know, large proportion to pay everybody enough to show up in one place
to do
a show.
You know, I think people forget that this all costs money. You know, you've got to fly there, or you've got to be there, and then you've got to make sure they get paid and everything else. It's very difficult, I think.
It is. And, you know, in Burn Unit, we did a gig up in Canada, in British Columbia, for the, it was the Boogie Bash.
Oh, how wonderful.
Last year. It was a lot of fun, but the cost of getting up there and doing the show and the logistics, basically.
But you got paid for it, though.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, yeah.
The time you pay out everything, you don't really gain much. But at the same time, you had the exposure.
Right. And so with the Deep Purple tribute, the gigs just weren't there
to
justify everybody being able to maintain the band over the distance that we had at that
absolutely.
Time. So.
But now with the band you're in at the moment, is this now able to sort of cover itself and do itself? Are you happy with
oh,
that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think. And we're actually going through a rebranding that I don't know if I should announce at this point, but...
Oh, no, don't be like the film coming. We're doing a film, we can't announce the name or where it is or when we're filming
But we are trying to expand a little bit and
you can't say the name?
It'll be Rock Nation.
Rock Nation. All right, Rock Nation.
Yeah,
why not? Put it out there.
The bands will coexist for a while, I guess, as Burn Unit, because we have New Year's Eve and we have some other shows coming up in January. It's on...
Is it all in Vegas or coming around?
Right now it's all in Vegas.
All in Vegas.
Right now.
Great. I want Vegas to support these bands. We've got to get... There's enough gigs, there's enough places to actually play now because they've opened up so many places.
Right.
So there's enough places and hotels and everything to have, you know, you performing and in each of the hotels and everything. I don't see why this can't happen.
Right. So we'll see how that goes with the, you know, once we get going with the new name. Basically the same band, but...
How do you practice once a week or at night, or you've got to practice, right?
Well, when we can, you know, everybody, a couple of the band members actually live in Utah, so a lot of times we are commuting one way or another for everybody to be able
to be collect. Together, yes, which is fine.
Right, it's not as far as the distances we ended up with in the previous band, with the Purple Band, with everybody being so much farther away.
Yes.
And
You sound very excited about this, Raven. Oh. You sound like you've really sort of like you've got it together. You've got it all going back out there again and everything. That's pretty. Live in Vegas, right?
Oh yeah, I grew up in Vegas. I was born in North Hollywood, but I've been here since about 71, 72.
Wow, you like
so,
it, obviously.
You know, my first memories of Vegas are looking out the Mint Hotel down on Fremont Street. looking at Vegas Vic, and I was just fascinated. I was, you know, maybe 4 years old, three, 4 years old.
Oh, wow. Amazing. So how can anybody reach you to book you?
Well, burnunitrocks.com is the website, and we're also on Facebook under Burn Unit, which all kind of scrunched into one word.
Burn Unit, one word, on Facebook, and you're on Instagram.
Or Burn Unit Vegas, I think, is
Burn
the actual Facebook.
Okay.
Extension of the name.
Okay. Fabulous.
And so that's how you contact the band to book the band.
And then you've got your gig coming up in the cannery this New Year's.
The Eastside Cannery,
Eastside Cannery, New Year's Eve. And then obviously you're going to get more things coming up and doing.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Wonderful. Well, Raven, I've known Raven for some time, and it's wonderful to have them, you know, back on my show, because I can find out where they're going, what they're doing, and you know, I think when you're in the music business or entertainment business, you never kind of lose it. You've always got it going. If you haven't got this band going, you'll make another band, and if you haven't got this gig going, you'll make another gig.
Well, I appreciate playing it all. I mean, you know, I'm just happy I can play it all. Still, you know, it's
isn't that nice to say? That's wonderful.
I feel fortunate. You know, it's hard to find a good band.
Yes,
really,
but you've got it together. You've got a band. You've got it together, and they're doing well.
Well, this band's been around since I've been in it for a couple years now. It existed for about 10 years prior, and cycled through quite a few members actually. Kelly is the oldest. Or I shouldn't say oldest. He's
the only one that's still in it.
Yeah, Roger Stevenson, our bass player, I guess, would be. Well, never mind. Kelly is the longest tenured in the band.
Okay, so it's a pretty prestigious band, and we will see them floating around Vegas and at different gigs and everything else. Don't forget to support them, and don't forget to support Vegas Live with Ninon, YouTube, subscribe, and all that stuff. Thank you for watching. Raven is amazing. We'll be right back with our next guest.